Good morning, students. Here I am, sir, with you in this class today. In today's class, we are going to discuss the chapter In the Kingdom of Fools. This is chapter number 4 of your Moments book. In this chapter, it is written by A.K. Ramanujan. And in this chapter, there is a discussion of a story of this kingdom where all the people behave like fools. And let's start this story or chapter. In the kingdom of fools, both the king and minister were idiots. In this kingdom of fools, both the minister and the king were idiots. They did not behave like other states, other kingdoms. They behaved like reverse way. They did not want to run things like other things. They did not want to run their kingdom like other things. So they decided to change night into day and day into night. So their order was that people were sleeping in the daytime and the people were working at the night time. So it was reverse order. And one more great thing or wonderful thing in that chapter, in this story, is that everything cost a dudu. A dudu is a currency there. So a dudu is a currency. Everything cost a dudu. All the things were of the simple or single rate. That was one dudu. That was amazing thing there. Dudu, you can say D U double D U. Everything cost one dudu. So everything was going in the reverse way. But one day a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. A guru and disciple came to the city. They wanted to enjoy and stay there to find their food. And they thought it is a wonderful city. But this guru thought that it is not an appropriate place. It is a place of foolish people. It is not easy and safe to stay here. So he told his disciple that please don't stay here. My son, please go with me. I will not stay here. It is really a kingdom of fools. Nothing is in a simple order or natural order. So one day you might face any difficulty or problem in your life. So please don't stay. But the disciple thought that everything is so at low cost in this city. So I will stay there. So they started, the disciple started living there. And the guru went away from there. One day something happened. What happened? A war. One bright day a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. A thief broke into a merchant's house. And a war fell on him. And he was dying. And his brother went to the court, told that the merchant's wall fell down on my brother, so I must be given some compensation or the merchant should be punished so that I can be compensated. So they went to the court, the bailiff, an officer, dealt with this problem. And when they went there, the king ordered the merchant should be called in the court. The merchant was called, he told that it is not my fault, it is the fault of bricklayer. Bricklayer means mason, mystery, who makes wall. So he was called, he told that it is not my fault. When I was building that wall, a dancing girl was going here to a goldsmith shop. So every time she went and came, I was disturbed by his jingling anklets. Jingling anklets means he had something weird or in his foot. So that disturbed his, that sound of anklets disturbed him. So he made a wrong wall, a built a wrong wall. And then the dancing girl was called. And then dancing girl, here the dancing girl, she told that I had to go many times to goldsmith because he did not repair my jewelry. So I had to go many times, so that I had to go and come from there so many times, that's why he was disturbed. So then the goldsmith was called. And goldsmith told that it is not my fault, it is merchant fault. I was in hurry to prepare merchant's jewelry. That's why I had to call so many times dancing girl. You should come to me tomorrow, you should come next day. That's why I had to call girl dancing girl so many times because of the merchant. Because he was in hurry of a marriage in his house. So that was a problem. At last the merchant was called and he was thought culprit. But merchant said, this is not my fault. The wall was built by my father. So where the king and ministers and all the court was confused. So whom should be hanged or whom should be punished? Because merchant said that it was his father's fault that he built that wall. It's not his fault. But at last, in the conclusion, the king ordered that merchant should be hanged because of his father's place. At his father's place. So when the merchant was being hanged and the stake was being ready, and when merchant was hanged, the stake was too loose and merchant slipped away from the stake and he survived. Then king ordered that there must be someone who can be fit according to the stake. So find in all the city or town anyone who will be fine, who will be fit and fine for that stake. So one time they found that whom they found? They found their disciple. Disciple was found because he was too healthy by eating there too much. So then he was called, and when he was to be hanged, he just recalled his great saint Guru. He called his Guru to save him. The Guru came and he built a story, false story. He told the king and minister that whoever first will be hanged, he will become the minister and king the next birth. So king and minister said that in place of Guru and disciple, we should be hanged. So because of the orders, king and minister were hanged, and all the people were rebelled from the kingdom of fools. And all the people appealed to save the Guru and disciple to be their king and minister, and to run that kingdom in a proper order of election. So and at that, after this time, the saint and disciple were made king and minister of that state. So this was the story here. Now we will discuss some questions in this chapter. What are the two strange things the Guru and disciple find? I have already sent you these question answers, but let's discuss one or two points. What are the two strange things? One strange thing is the day and night were in reverse order, and everything was the same one to do. And why does the disciple decide to stay in the kingdom of fools? He decided because everything was at low cost, it was easy to survive there, and he could enjoy his life there. Name all the people who were tried in the court. So you can discuss all the people who were tried: merchant, thief, blacksmith, bricklayer, dancing girl, goldsmith, king, and these were the people who were tried in the court. So who was the real culprit? According to merchant was the real culprit, but he told his father was the real culprit, but still merchant was punished for that. And what are the Guru's words of wisdom? The Guru's words of wisdom were: never stay any place which is not natural in order of people of fool or fool kingdom of fools. Never stay at the place where nothing is in order and nothing is sure. People are very absurd. So how does the Guru manage to stay? He went there, he prepared a story and befooled king and minister and saved the life of his disciple. This was the chapter. I have already sent you the story, the summary and some questions of this chapter. Still you have a doubt, please call me, you can contact me, ask any doubt, read this chapter easily, then I have sent you a summary on the WhatsApp group, read that summary and do the question answers given below after the summary. So it was nice chapter. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.